हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू दिस सेशन ऑन फिगर्स ऑफ स्पीच और लिटरेरी टर्म्स. आवर लास्ट टर्म वाज सिंबलिज्म. एज सिंबलिज्म इज यूज्ड टू मेक द टेक्स्ट मोर इम्प्रेसिव, इंटेंस एंड कॉम्प्लेक्स. इन द सेम वे टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द टर्म पैराडॉक्स. तलाश कीजिए, खजाना यहीं से निकलेगा. वो भूखा नंगा फकीर यहीं रहता था. और I always lie. Or we have sometimes to be cruel to be kind. These statements are paradoxical. So what paradox is? Paradox is a self-contradictory statement, but this statement turns out to have a valid meaning on close observation. इन हिंदी इट इज़ कॉल्ड विरोधाभास. जो देखने में गलत दिखाई दे लेकिन अगर ध्यान से देखा, पढ़ा, समझा जाए तो वो बिल्कुल राइट होता है. टू टॉक अबाउट द ओरिजिन ऑफ द टर्म पैराडॉक्स, दिस इज फ्रॉम द ग्रीक पैराडॉक्सन. पैराडॉक्सन, पैराडॉक्सन मीन्स बिसाइड और बियॉन्ड ओपिनियन. ओरिजिनली paradox was a statement which contradicted accepted opinion. By roundabout the middle of the 16th century, the word had acquired the commonly accepted meaning it now has, that it is a self-contradictory statement and on close observation it turns out to have a valid meaning. More haste, less speed is a well-known paradox. Metaphysical poets like Donne used it in abundance. For example, in his sonnet, Death Be Not Proud, written 1600, published 1603, Donne writes, Death, thou shalt die. You have read this poem in your compulsory paper in BA first year, and I hope you remember it very well. Because of its paradoxical statements, because its paradoxical theme. It's difficult to understand how death shall die. But paradox is used because this is the only way in which Donne can come to terms with the difficult Christian idea of life after death. Clint Brook, in his book The Well-Wrought Urn of 47, argued that it was not only metaphysical poetry such as Donne's that used paradox, but the language of poetry is itself the language of paradox. Basically, two types of paradox may be distinguished, local or particular. Local paradox is short, pithy statement which verge on the epigram, such as Hamlet's line, I must be cruel only to be kind, or Congreve's neat turn of the phrase in Amoret, careless she is with artful care, affecting to seem unaffected. A structural paradox is one which is integral to a poem. The works of metaphysical poets, Donne and Andrew Marvell, abound in them. John Donne wrote a collection of paradoxes and problems in prose also. He also exploited this figure fully in his poem, The Canonization. For example, is organized as an extended proof full of local paradoxes of the paradoxical thesis that sexual lovers are saints. Other examples are The Will, Good Friday, Riding Westward, in the sonnet Death Be Not Proud. Marvell's poem The Garden depends on a central paradoxical idea. In modern times, apart from G.B. Shaw, an expert is J.K. Chesterton. A striking series of paradoxes can be found at the beginning of T.S. Eliot's Little Gidding. With paradox, we also talk about oxymoron. What it is? If the paradoxical utterance combines two terms that in ordinary usage are contrary, it is called an oxymoron. An example is Tennyson's O Death in Life, the days that are no more. Elizabethan love poetry used oxymoron in abundance, like pleasing pains, loving hate, I burn and freeze. This oxymoron is also a frequent figure in devotional prose and religious poetry, as Milton describes the appearance of God in Paradise Lost, 3rd, 380, dark with excessive bright, thy skirts appear. So that was about paradox, that it's a self-contradictory statement, but on close observation, this is perfectly right. It's of two types, general or structural or local or particular, and with it, the combined term is oxymoron. Now for your activity, try to find out the paradox in poetry of your syllabus, read them carefully and find out where the paradoxical statements are there. Well, from exams point of view, in the last year question papers, for 2 marks, the question was asked, explain the term paradox. And for 20 marks, the question was like this, that define the term paradox and giving examples from the text prescribed in your course. Hope you have understood the term and will try to find out the paradox in your poetry and in prose also. Thank you for joining today's class. Thank you.